Hello, I will talk to you about the causes of severe erectile dysfunction. Severe erectile dysfunction, meaning persistent and resistant to medication, is not of psychological origin, but is due to diseases, primarily the arteries and veins, that are responsible for these erections. The most common causes are cavernous venous leaks. What are the causes of cavernous venous leaks? The answer is complex. I will try to respond as simply as possible. I remind you what this condition is, during which blood flows well into the penis, but it leaves too soon. However, it is the accumulation of blood in the penis that allows for the hardness of the erection. In this condition, blood flows in. The blood returns to the general circulation too early. This is called venous leaks. What can we say about the causes? It is important to note that there are two main circumstances for the occurrence of cavernous venous leaks. They can appear as early as adolescence, or before the age of 30. We then talk about primary leaks. Conversely, it can occur after a completely satisfactory erectile life, around the ages of 40, 50, or even 60. This is referred to as secondary erectile dysfunction, caused by cavernous venous leaks. In primary forms, which occur from a young age, it is believed to be due to venous malformations, possibly malformations of the tunica albuginea, the sheath that surrounds the cavernous bodies, which also plays a role in retaining blood. In short, a malformation. Conversely, when it appears secondarily, it is a kind of wear on the system that retains blood in the penis. We see patients who describe the use of objects such as rings and pumps in an extremely aggressive manner. In some of these patients, there are more or less violent traumas that are the source of the problem. It is also known, still in the context of traumas, that there are men who have experienced a direct, violent trauma to the penis, and that afterwards they developed cavernous venous leaks. This violent shock can be a direct trauma against a pillar, against a motorcycle, etc. A type of penile fracture. And secondary to this penile fracture, the occurrence of cavernous venous leaks. You see, the only somewhat reasonable explanation we have is that of traumas. But I want to emphasize one thing, because again in consultations, men are often very, very anxious and ask me, is it because I have masturbated a lot? To which the answer is no. The penile system is designed to function well, even with frequent use. So no, it is not the uses of the penis that are responsible, including masturbation, particularly due to cavernous venous leaks. Therefore, there should be absolutely no fear or guilt associated with this. It is a condition that occurs, and we are not quite sure why. The important thing is to make the diagnosis. It is the fact that it can be effectively treated through a combination of techniques during the same operation, which uses both a scalpel and a catheter, that is to say, types of tubes that allow for embolizations, meaning to block the arteries at the bottom of the pelvis. You can share this video. Thank you for that. It is extremely important that as many men as possible have this information. You can also like it. And of course, you can ask questions related to this video. I will respond as quickly as possible and in the best way.